Most everyone's familiar with the periodic table of the elements that was put together by the Russian chemist Dmitri Mendeleev more than 150 years ago. What many do not know is that this achievement would not have been possible without the incredible sacrifice of his mother. Maria Kornilieva Mendeleev was forced to support her family after her husband went blind and lost his job as a high school principal in Tobolsk, Siberia. She reopened her family's shuttered glass factory and ran it until it burned down in 1847. At that point, her husband had passed away, most of her 14 children had been raised, and her youngest, Dmitri, was 13. Maria recognized Dmitri's remarkable abilities and potential, and how the lack of higher education in the backwater of Siberia limited his possibilities. So in 1849, she undertook the arduous journey to enroll Dmitri at Moscow State University. Maria traveled with Dmitri and his sister, roughly 1,300 miles over the Ural Mountains, hitchhiking with strangers on horse-drawn wagons, only to find that the university's quota system had no provision for students from Siberia. Exhausted but undeterred, Maria set out for Saint Petersburg, an additional 400 miles, where she secured Dmitri a place to study chemistry at the Saint Petersburg Central Pedagogical Institute. Just 10 weeks later, a worn-out Maria fell ill and died. Dmitri was only 15 years old. On her deathbed, she gave Dmitri these final words: refrain from illusion, insist on work, not words, and patiently seek divine and scientific truth. 19 years later, Dmitri, now a chemistry professor at the University of St. Petersburg, recognized that the elements seemed to be best organized when they were aligned with elements that had similar characteristics. These recurring patterns were published as the periodic table of the elements. He was so confident in his periodic order that he predicted the existence and the property of undiscovered elements, three of which were discovered within the next 15 years. Maria's devotion, sacrifice, and final words had an enduring effect on her son. He recalled these words some 30 years later in the preface of a book he wrote. "To me, the periodic table is truly a thing of beauty. Its recognizable shape and structure display patterns that reveal the underlying structure and order of the elements. It's sublime." However, the story of Maria's love for her son, her recognition of his abilities, her sacrifice, and her lasting inspiration is a beautiful, transcendent story, which reminds us that there is a human dimension behind the creation of everything of beauty. As I've pondered this story, I've been reminded of our own obligation to see potential, not only in our own children, but in others, and then to eagerly work to fulfill that vision. That is a thing of beauty.